Making a base for a sculpture.
What are you using to cut it, though?
Well, this is the oxygen acetylene, of course. Because it's a piece of 1-inch blade, my plasma cutter won't reach all the way through it. So we had to get out old school here and cut it apart with a flaming scissors. This is my circle cutter off of my plasma cutter. Because the plasma cutter wouldn't work on this because the metal's too thick, I adapted it to fit my oxygen acetylene rig. Just a battery clamp, just almost the right size to fit on the cutting tip. And then I got some of this, I believe it's called flame blocker. You get it like an Ace Hardware, like for when you're soldering like on copper pipe in a wall. And it just looked like a black cloth, but it blocks a lot of the heat transfer. So you can put this up against the wall when you're using your torch in the house, so you don't set the wall on fire. So I cut a little chunk of it off and use that for a little bushing. You can see it right there in between the clamp and the torch.
Here, let me get a close-up of
that. Yeah, come here. Come here, check it out. I just cut a little piece and put it in there, and I close the clamp up on it. And that helps keep the heat from the torch from melting the lead clamp. Yeah, it will. So now I got a circle cutter rig for my oxygen acetylene. So I can go ahead and finish cutting this out. And I won't have quite as big a mess to clean up as if I tried to do it freehand. So let me finish what I'm doing here. We'll see you next time.